Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today let's look at some tips to help you type faster on your iPhone. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 750 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So typing on the iPhone isn't ideal. Just tapping those little keys on the screen can be much slower than using a real keyboard. But if you learn some tricks, you can increase your speed. So first, let's look at predictive text. These are the three words that appear above the keyboard as you type. Now, when you start using this, it doesn't necessarily make you any faster. But if you practice, you can definitely increase your speed over time. This is true for just about everything I'm going to show you. You have to kind of dedicate yourself to learning and using that tool. And then over time, your speed will slowly increase as you use it more. So as I type here, and I tap out the letters, you can notice that it gives me suggestions at the top. So I start typing the word quick, and you can see eventually it gets what I want to type. And instead of having to type two more letters and then space, I can just tap that word there. It'll type it out, put a space, and I'm ready for the next word. It'll even try to predict what the next word will be based on the context. So sometimes I can skip typing entirely and just tap the word. Now if you don't see these three words there, you may have turned it off in settings. A lot of things we're going to show you can be turned on and off in settings. A quick way to get to keyboard settings from the keyboard is to tap and hold at the bottom left corner and then go to keyboard settings. And then here you could see a lot of those. So if I scroll down here I could see predictive and you could see I have it turned on. Now a much faster way to type is to use slide to type. This allows you to, instead of tapping each letter individually, you can tap the first letter, keep your finger pressed down, and slide around on the keyboard to the other letters. And you don't have to hit them each perfectly. It's going to try to figure out what you mean. So I'll do this for the next word here. And you can see it was a much faster action than actually tapping each letter out. And every time I do this, it's going to insert the space automatically. In order for this to work, you really have to dedicate yourself to doing it. So start doing it and force yourself to use it each time. And then it kind of becomes natural. And then you find that you can type way faster than you can by tapping out each letter. Now let's say you want to type a key that isn't on the current keyboard. Maybe you have to hit Shift to get a capital letter, or you have to hit the 1-2-3 key at the bottom left to get that. The natural way to handle that, you would think, is to tap that number key, find what you want, like say a number, tap that, and then tap the ABC key to go back to letters. However, you can do that in one motion. If you tap and hold, drag your finger up to the key that you want, release, it automatically switch back to the previous keyboard mode. And you can use this for almost anything. So I can do it for Shift, for instance. I can tap, drag, and then release over that key. And you can see I typed the capital letter in one motion. Now sometimes you need to type an accent mark or alternative character, and you can do that in a similar way that you type on a Mac, where you would press the key and hold it to see the alternatives. So if I wanted to type the letter E with an accent mark, I could tap and hold E, wait for those alternatives to appear, slide my finger over to the one I want, and release to get that letter with that accent mark. It also works for alternatives. So for instance, if I tap the 1-2-3 key there, I can see the dash key on the left, where there are various sizes to dashes. If I tap and hold, I can see them all. Now part of typing is correcting mistakes, and the biggest way to correct a mistake is to use undo. In iOS 13, there's a really simple way to use undo. So for instance, if I want to undo this word here, I could just take three fingers and swipe to the left, and it will undo and show you at the top. Three fingers swipe to the right will redo. Now you can also use three fingers to undo, redo, or copy and paste. Just tap in the middle of the screen with three fingers, and you get controls at the top. They are undo at the left and redo at the right. In the middle, you have cut, copy, and paste. Now while working with text, you may want to go back and insert some text or work with some text in the middle. And one way to do that is to kind of tap where you want the cursor to go. But sometimes that can be a little difficult, especially if the text is smaller and you have lots of it. You can tap and hold the space bar on the keyboard, and it turns basically the keyboard into a trackpad. Now I can drag my finger around and position the cursor exactly where I want. Now a great way to type quickly is not to type at all. You can set up text replacements for things and substitute a few characters for a lot of characters. Let's go into settings here. I'm going to tap at the bottom left, go to keyboard settings, and then at the top here I'm going to tap on text replacement. And here's where I can add a new text replacement. So at the top type the entire phrase, and you can use something as long as you want. So something like this. And then you just have to have a shortcut. So let's just do something like XSUP for support there, but it's not a real word, so I would never need to actually type this. Now I'm going to hit save. Now let's go back to notes, and if I type that and then just hit space, you can see it inserts the entire thing. Actually notice that the predictive text even had it there at the top, and I could have just tapped it. So you can have little common phrases or things you need, or maybe a long email address that's difficult to type, or a whole set of paragraphs of different things that you want to insert very easily. Now what happens if you're holding your phone with one hand and you're trying to type with your thumb? Well, there's a mode for the keyboard that makes it a little easier to type. If I tap and hold down there at the bottom, I can choose to move the keyboard over to the left or the right. So let's try the left here, and you can see it condenses the keyboard and makes it a little bit easier for me to reach all the keys with my thumb. To turn it off, I can either tap in that area over the right or just repeat the same thing and select the regular keyboard. Now of course another way to type without typing is to use dictation. There's a built-in dictation function. You see it at the bottom right hand corner of your keyboard. It's great for basically typing one sentence at a time by talking. Lazy dog, period. And just tap the keyboard there at the bottom to go back into regular typing mode. There's no reason you can't combine these. So you could be typing things out and then maybe tap the microphone, speak out a few things, then go back to regular typing. Use the space bar as a trackpad to go back and quickly correct something. Now if you're sitting down at a desk or something and you want to type on your iPhone faster, nothing beats using a regular keyboard. There's no reason you can't use just about any Bluetooth keyboard to quickly type on your iPhone. You can pair a keyboard just like any other Bluetooth device. In settings, go to Bluetooth and you should see it appear there. Follow the instructions for your keyboard to put it into pairing mode, and then I could select it, and once it's paired up I can then use this keyboard to type very easily. You can also do a lot of the things that you're used to doing on a Mac keyboard. So for instance, I can use Shift and left arrow to select something. I can do Command C to copy. I can use the arrows to move around. I can do Command V to paste, that kind of thing. So here are some quick bonus tips. You don't need to type the period at the end of a sentence. You can just type spacebar twice. So for instance, the end of the sentence here, I can just type space twice and it inserts the period and the space. If I want the caps lock to stay on, all I need to do is double tap the Shift key there at the bottom left, and you can see now it's at caps lock. So now I could type something loud and then just tap the Shift key once to turn it off. If you're in a situation where you're typing a web page address, you can tap and hold the period key and get common domain name endings like .com and just release to type that. And you can always go and get a third party keyboard that helps you with typing in some way. There are a variety of different companies that provide third party keyboards. You can see here if I tap at the bottom left, I can go to keyboard settings, and here I've got keyboards 2. Tap that and you can see I've just got the two standard keyboards. But if I tap add new keyboard, you can see it recognizes that I have an app that is a keyboard extension, and that's the Google app. It has Gboard as a keyboard there. So now I can switch to using Google's special keyboard. Just by tapping here, you can see I can switch to the Google keyboard, and now I get a different looking keyboard there with some different functionality. If you search the App Store for third party keyboards, you'll find a variety of different apps that provide these special keyboards. So you may find something that you like if you look around and try some. So I hope these tips help you type a little bit faster on your iPhone. I think the important thing is to pick something like Predictive Text or Slide to Type and practice it. Keep using it. And you may not see improvement in speed right away, but you start to gradually see it over the course of days as you get better and better at using that technique. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.